clearly applaud that I am the ambassador of the month. I'm so happy about this. To be answering a few questions that the Zahara team has sent me that you have asked, let's get started. So the first question is, tell us a bit about yourself. So my name is Julia Pylad. I am 20 years old. I live in Sweden in a city called Norrköping. I am originally from the countryside, from St. Anna as it's called. But right now I live in the city called Norrköping. I am right now a student. I'm studying to become a teacher. I'm also working at preschools and I'm doing some modeling and yeah. Next question is, what's on your bucket list? The first thing that I think of is that I want to visit every Greek island. And I have visited a few, but not all of them, so that's definitely on my bucket list. I would also say that on my bucket list, I want to, when I'm older and I have my own house and stuff like that, I want to adopt some rescued dogs because I think it's so amazing that those organizations exist and they are, you know, saving and helping so many dogs and cats and other pets. So I would definitely want to contribute to that in any way that I can. I would also have on my bucket list, of course, to become a mother. If you could have dinner with 5 people in the world, whoever you want, who would you choose? I would choose, the first one I think of is absolutely Catriona Gray because I think she's amazing. She's the former Miss Universe. So this is a very random group of people, I think. But I would also pick Ellen DeGeneres because I love her. And the third, I would choose J. Cole because if you know me, you know that I'm obsessed with J. Cole. I love his lyrics, I love his songs. So then I have 2 spots left. I couldn't say this, you know, this list for people that I want to go on a date with without naming my closest friend, Sana Kumalic, and of course my boyfriend, Yuki Yuansal. I would definitely bring them with me. So the next question is, what song or artist are you obsessed with at the moment? And as I said before, I'm always obsessed with J. Cole, but I'm also always obsessed with Imagine Dragons. So J. Cole and Imagine Dragons. And if I would say someone that I listen to a lot right now, it would be Daniel Caesar because I love the, you know, the chill mood of his songs. So the next question is, if you could go back and tell your childhood self an advice, what would it be? When I was younger, I was really shy. Not really shy in that way, but I was very conscious about what other people thought about me. You know, very often I was making up in my head, you know, the people have all these negative thoughts about me. And that so many people, you know, thought badly of me. Really care what people thought about me and what people thought about what I did and what I didn't and everything like that. So now that I'm older, but I still have this these kind of problems now, of course, they don't just disappear, but I would definitely tell my childhood self to, you know, have the belief in yourself that you know who you are and you know who you aren't, because we all have flaws, but remember that you should go after your own beliefs and what you want to do, and you should not let people's thought about you stop you. You should definitely, as I did, you should definitely not let your own mind set boundaries for you about what you can do and what you can't. So if you have those kind of problems that I have had, you know, these social anxiety thoughts, I know what you're going through. Just remember who you are and remember that you know who you are the best. So the next questions are about Zahara Swim. I'm so excited to answer these questions. What is your favorite Zahara Swim bikini or swimsuit? So it's pretty clear that the Dream Chaser is my favorite swimsuit if you check my Instagram. And I'm wearing it right now and I just love it. I think it's amazing. The fabric, the quality, everything about Zahara Swim is just amazing. And I'm not just saying that because I'm their ambassador, I promise. That leads us to the next question, which is, how has your experience been with Zahara Swim so far? My experience with Zahara Swim has been so amazing. I became their ambassador last fall. They're always so kind, so supportive. Even, you know, in January when I was traveling to Mexico for a contest, I was able to represent Zahara Swim there, and I was so happy about them being so supportive and so kind and, you know, really supporting me all the way in that competition. I recommend Zahara Swim to everyone that I meet, and, you know, if you're looking for new bikinis or swimsuits or even athletic wear, I'm so excited that they have launched the Zahara Fit. I haven't tried it yet, but I'm so excited to try the Zahara Fit collection. What are your future goals? My future goals are to finish studying. I don't know if I, you know, if teacher is the thing that I'm gonna graduate in, if I'm gonna continue, or if I'm going to maybe change my path a little bit. But either way, I'm having as my goal to just graduate and find the job that is the perfect one for me. My nearest in the future goal is, of course, now in about 2 weeks I'm going to the top model finals in London, and I'm so excited about that. So that is absolutely my goal, to just, you know, dare to go through with it and do my best there. Your favorite movie of all time? I have always said, when I got this question, I have always said the same movie ever since like a couple of years ago. ever since I saw it the first time, and that movie is Inception. I love, you know, the psychology, and I love the storyline, and it's amazing. I'm just putting out a warner that if you see that movie, you're gonna be so frustrated about the ending. But it's so good, so I really recommend it still. What would be your ideal date? As I said, I love the Greek islands, but I also, like, my dream destination would be the Maldives. So I would say my ideal date would be either at a Greek island or in the Maldives, you know, maybe having a picnic on the beach and listening to music and, yeah, like, just, you know, chilling and, yeah, having fun. What countries have you visited? So I have traveled to a few countries, but mostly inside of Europe. Mexico is the first country that I visited that was outside of Europe. Inside of Europe, I have traveled to Spain multiple times because my family has an apartment there. I have also traveled to Malta for a language course, and Greece, England. I traveled to Finland, I think, when I was really, really young, on one of those cruises, you know? Also, like, the Netherlands and Germany for a few hours. You know, having one of these stops on the plane at the north, that counts, but yeah. I don't remember one more. I think that's that. I think so. Maybe I forgot about a country, but I don't know. I don't think so. But maybe, I don't. So the next question is kind of hard. The next question is, what is something that people may not know about you? This is hard because I don't know what to say. I've always been playing soccer, and my family has always had horses, so I have always been, what's it called in English? Horse riding? I don't know. You know what I mean? So to get back at the Miss Global story that I was talking a little bit about before, I went to Mexico for a contest in January. If you follow me on Instagram, you know that journey ended in a kind of chaotic way, but it was such a great experience. We were there for a couple of weeks and I met so many amazing people, and we got to travel around in Mexico, and we got to experience such amazing things. So I'm still so happy about that trip, no matter the ending. But something that people may not know about that trip was that it, for me, was a really, really huge step. Visiting a foreign country with people I don't know. I think that's a big step for anyone to do, but it was such a huge step for me since I hate being in the center of attention. I hate standing out. I hate drawing attention to me. I just want to be in the corner always. Because, yeah, I feel more comfortable in that place. Also, you know, having dealt with social anxiety for a very long time, it was so scary, to be honest, to, you know, take that step and dare to do that. But I did, and I'm so happy that I did that. The next question is, do you have any pets? And I do have. I have this little girl. She's called Geisha. She's a petite Brabant Con, if you know that breed. It's a type of the Griffon breed. I also have a cat called Wilder. The next question is, if you had 30 minutes a day to do anything you wanted, what would you do? Pick together all my family and friends and everything like that. Everyone who's close to my heart, and no, just go somewhere with them and just spend time with them, because I think time is so precious. What is one thing that can make you feel better when you're having a bad day? It's always to, you know, talk with the ones who's close to me. Besides that, I definitely listen to music, because that can they can really affect my mood so much. So when I'm sad, I like to listen to music, and when I'm sad, it's often like Bonnie Tyler or something. But if I'm sad and I really want to feel better, or if I'm happy and want to get happier, I always listen to my road trip playlist on Spotify with all these throwback songs. And yeah, I love the 90s R&B, so I often listen to that. When you were younger, what did you want to become when you grew up? So this is so random. When I was younger, I wanted to become a penguin scientist. And that's because I was watching the Discovery Channel, and there were these scientists on the Antarctica, I think it's called, in English. And they were studying these penguins, and I fell in love, and I was like, I want to do that too. So I always said that I wanted to become a penguin scientist. Your best TV shows recommendations. If I would name, okay, I'll name three, and I've just finished Casa de Papel, or Money Heist, as it's also called. And I would also say Prison Break, that's a classic. And also third, I would say The 100. I really like The 100, although I haven't watched the latest season, but yeah. Oh, I also, like yesterday, I was starting to watch The Travelers TV show on Netflix. So if you have seen that, I am only on the fourth episode, so I don't know exactly. But right now it's really, really good. So if you want to watch a new TV show, or I don't know if the TV show is new, but if you haven't watched it already, I would definitely recommend it. Would you rather live in a place where it's always raining, or live in a place where the sun never goes down? It's not hard for me to answer this question, because I love the sun. Even the rain can be so cozy, you know, when you're inside and you're watching a movie and it's raining outside, and yeah, it's so cozy. But you know, that compared to having sun, I get so much happier when it's sunny outside, and you can do all these things that you can't do when it's raining. So yeah, I would definitely say live in a place where the sun never goes down, compared to living in a place where it's raining all the time. So we are now at the very last question, and the last question is, do you have any advice for the Sahara Swim girls? I think that the Sahara girls are such amazing girls. You are so strong, and you're so, you know, empowering females. So I'm really happy to see that. If I could give the Sahara girls any advice, I think it would be to dare to do whatever you want. even if you're sitting at home and you really want to make this big change, whether if it's in your career or if it's something else, just dare to take the step. I really learned that no matter how afraid you are and how insecure you are about something, if you really want to do it, I believe in that you can and that you at least can try, because you never know the outcome. If you try your best and you don't succeed, then you can be so happy that you have tried your best, and you can be so proud. So dare to take the step and dare to do whatever you want if you want to do it. Don't let your fear stop you. So thank you so much for watching this video. I'm so happy to have been doing this Q&A with Zahara Swim. Thank you so much once again to Zahara Swim for making me your ambassador of the month. I'm so happy about that. If you want to stay in touch with me, you can follow me and contact me on my Instagram at juliapylad. I hope to keep in touch with you, and I hope you like this Q&A. Thank you so much.